My name is Dan Barilli. I'm the assistant product manager for the Sprinter van. And we're here down in Charleston, South Carolina. That's the U.S. home of the Sprinter. Part of the reason we're here is we had model year 14, which was a big improvement for the Sprinter van. We made a major change to it. The designers gave the front a more purposeful look, as well as we were really happy to introduce a new standard diesel engine. We've always had a V6 diesel engine, but with model year 14, we added a four-cylinder diesel engine as well as a 7-speed transmission, which took the Sprinter's already wonderful fuel economy and raised the bar even higher. Also with model year 14, we introduced a lot of safety systems, blind spot assist, lane keeping assist, collision prevention assist, which will help you avoid an accident. For model year 15, we've added even more features to the Sprinter. We added standard crosswind assist, so if you're driving on the highway and you get a strong gust of wind, it'll help keep you in your lane. Some other features, the one we're probably most proud of, is our optional four-wheel drive. We offer two different versions of four-wheel drive, a high range and a low and a high range. We think it's a great way that you can get a four-wheel drive system right from the factory and take your business wherever it needs to go, off-road, through bad weather. You know, this product is a tool, and it helps you get your equipment and your business where you need to go.
Today I'm showing adaptive ESP, how it works, and what the benefits of the system are. Now the best way to show it is by turning the system off. And when we turn the system off, we can actually show what happens to a vehicle when you don't have it. And when I turn it back on, you can see how well the system works. So we've turned the system off. We're going to run at 30 miles an hour and avoid around our cones. Now in the vehicle, I've got about 1,400 pounds of water, which are strapped up against the ceiling of the vehicle. And I've got about 800 pounds of steel, so we've got a lot of weight in here. So we're coming up to my obstacles at about 30 miles an hour, and I'm just going to steer around it. All right, and that would have been a vehicle rollover. You could hear the outrigger hit the ground, and that would have been a vehicle rollover. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to turn the system back on, and we're going to carry a little bit more speed. So for me to turn the system back on, I have to cycle the ignition, turn my special key, start the vehicle back up, and you'll see there's no more lights on the dashboard. They're all turned off now. Everything is off. We're going to go up to 40 miles an hour. Now once I get up to speed, I'm going to put my right foot right on the floor over here, and that shows that I'm not doing any braking. All right? Any braking you feel is going to be done by the computer. It's not me. A little bit more speed, system back on. So whereas in our previous run, we would have had a vehicle run over at 30 miles an hour with the system off. The system is on now. We're going to bring the vehicle up to about 40 miles an hour. Here we go, 40 miles an hour. The big difference there. The vehicle didn't even attempt to roll over. So more speed, less risk. Amazing. So if we were to look at our 2014 Sprinter, and this is my Sprinter right here, our yaw sensor was measuring this. It was measuring rotation, like this. And that was really a understeer or an oversteer skid. And when we would get into a skid like that, what would happen is we would apply brakes to one wheel to try to compensate for that. Now, move forward to 2015, and we've recalibrated the yaw sensor, and so not only does it measure the rotation this way, but what it will also do is it'll measure lateral movement this way. So if it gets hit by a wind, it measures that movement. And when that happens, it triggers brake action on two wheels on the side where the wind is coming from. All right, and when it does that, it pulls the vehicle back into its lane. So how do we demonstrate that? That becomes a bit of a challenge. So what we've got over there is I've got three airboats. They all have 600 horsepower V8s on them. They're all capable of running in excess of 100 miles an hour. They're pushing a wind of 90 miles an hour, and we're going to drive right beside them. So the way that I'm going to demonstrate it is Melanie is driving the red van over there. And it does not, it's a 2014, it does not have crosswind assist. I do have it in this van. So you're gonna see when she goes through that wind area, that van moves over. The wind pushes it away. It's 90 mile an hour wind. When I come through, you're going to feel this slight movement like this. And what's happening is the wind is hitting it, the sensors are being triggered, it pulls it back. And it's just keeping the vehicle in a straight line. And it's really quite dynamic how it works.
Using the brakes, right?
It uses the brakes to okay. keep me in line.
Okay.
All right. It reacts instantaneously. As soon as it feels it, it activates. Sound good? Got a seatbelt on back there, Klaus?
You driving?
Yes.
Of course. Now watch that van, that's our reference, okay?
What we're showing here today is a showcase of our Sprinter Preferred Upfitters. There are about 75 different companies that our engineers have worked with and reviewed their designs and preferred them to work on our Sprinter vans. And we're here with companies like Airstream, with companies like Morgan Olson that has a factory right near us. They'll take a Sprinter van and add a box that has 5,000 pounds of payload. Miranda's another company, Midway. All these companies work with us as partners to take the Sprinter van and turn it into something to help you get the job done. So we're inside one of my favorite Mercedes-Benz Sprinters. This is actually the Autobahn, and it's designed by our preferred upfitter, Airstream. And you can see it's pretty much a mobile office on wheels here. And you have seating for eight, and of course you have Wi-Fi, so you can be productive while you're traveling. We have tables that you can pull out and have a laptop with, a Blu-ray DVD player. People can use it to be more productive. It might replace traveling a short distance in a jet or something like that. This creative use here has replaced things like a luxury limousine or a stretch limousine, where you can actually be productive and also travel in some style.
I'm Ken Klein from Morgan Olson. We are just down the road here from the Daimler reassembly facility here in Charleston, South Carolina. This vehicle right here, we're very proud of. It's a new design, and we've finally broken over that 5,000 pound threshold. I think when you compare the Sprinter cab chassis box truck solutions to the other brands that are out there, you'll find 5,000 pounds isn't available, only on the Sprinter Morgan Olson LDX. What we've got going on with our LDX body here is a new, completely constructed, lightweight body on a Sprinter cab chassis. The reinforced sidewalls, the aluminum floor on top of the refrigeration unit is going to open us up to an entire new market share as far as from grocers to florists to medical supplies, whoever needs a refrigerated cargo truck. We're best known for our UDV, which has the side door that gives curbside access. These are the technologies from our walk-in vans that we've made in the past, but the Sprinter gives us a more fuel-efficient cab chassis, which allows customers to get more fuel efficiency, more miles to a gallon. So the curbside, what's nice about this is the cab to cargo access, actually the driver doesn't have to step out into traffic. He can go from the cab to the cargo area, get his produce, get his product, and exit on the curbside. And it's a much safer solution as far as for delivery vehicles.